everybody. I'm Nikki. This cutie right here, this is Camper, and we live in this 2006 Toyota Prius. Today we are tuning in from Connecticut. It is a hot and humid day, let me tell you.
Hi.
You guys, it is 95 degrees and humid today. We are visiting my parents for the week, and I thought that would be the perfect opportunity to show you a no-build
car camper conversion.
So if you guys have been following me, you know that I took out all of my seats except for my driver's seat. I have a roof box. I have a bike rack. I have a very souped up Prius. But what you might not know is my entire first year, I had nothing fancy. So I thought I would take the opportunity to take my mom's Prius and set it up exactly how I would have done it when I first started, and basically teach you everything I wish I knew. Here's a picture of what my car looked like when I first moved into it about 2 years ago. Crazy, I know. But it just goes to show it can be done and anyone can do it, and you don't need a fancy rig. You ready? Let's take you to mom's Prius. Let's do this. Rule number one, before you even get into your car, before you even outfit it to live in it or car camp for the weekend, make sure you are ready for emergencies.
No, God, please, no, no!
Or just things that happen. For instance, if your tire blows, do you have a spare? Do you have your repair kit? Do you have an air compressor? Do you have your tools? Do you have your jack? Make sure that is in your car. I also have two different jumper cable setups. So I have just long jumper cables just in case, and my car battery jump starter. I have regular jumper cables, but what if nobody comes by? You wanna have that thing charged up so you can jump yourself, or let's say your car's in the wrong direction. It's happened to me like 3 times. It's great to have the peace of mind that you can drive anywhere without worrying about a flat battery leaving you stranded. Now that we've gone over safety, let's talk about essentials and what you're gonna be using. Are you gonna be sleeping in a tent, or are you gonna be sleeping in your car? Personally, I like having the option of both. So first thing you're gonna want is a great tent. I personally use a 2-person backpacking tent because I love backpacking and I want it for both when I'm sleeping outside. But you might like a simple pop-up tent, like the one I got for my mom. Those are amazing. You're watching people set up and you're done in like 15 seconds. As you'll see in my car, I have a literal full-size mattress. Now, if you're doing the no build or you want something smaller, they have a lot of different things you can use. Now, this is just a self-inflating pad. These are really great because they also roll up really small and they get about this big. Game changer. Another thing you could do that I used to do all the time is I would fly into a place and I would get an air mattress. I would blow it up in the back of the minivan. My first time, I used a memory foam. There's so many different ways. See what works for you, try it out. Now, with that, very important, you're gonna want an amazing sleeping bag. I have a 0-degree sleeping bag in my car because I'm frequently in very cold weather. Another thing to think about with your sleeping bag is insulation and shape. There's so many different ones, so do your research, make sure you're getting a great sleeping bag. You know, even just bringing a down quilt, just decide what you want to do for layers, because it does get cold at night, don't forget that. Which brings me to my next essential item. If you are going to be sleeping inside the car, you need this. It basically goes over your car door like a glove, and it keeps the bugs out, it keeps the dust out, and allows airflow. If you're gonna do it, you need one of these, best purchase of the year. Besides my table. Actually, this is better than the table, for sure, because you can use your car as a table. Something you're gonna wanna do is have about a 2-inch gap on each window. That way there's constant airflow. One window's not enough, do both. A lot of people I know sleep in their car with the windows all the way up, and they wonder why there's so much condensation. Even when it's freezing out, it's important to have these windows cracked to prevent that wet cold. Next, I have my solar fan. This I will actually have in the dash, charging up through the sun. It's really nice to have a fan, especially on those hot days. I also have this on a carabiner so I can hang it from one of the poop handles. I'll hang it from there so that way the air with the window down, it can come right through. Another item I really like is these dehumidifying bags. Basically, this dot turns pink when it absorbs all the water, and you can go to a gas station or a truck stop or somewhere with a microwave, put it in for 6 minutes, and you're ready to go again. So this does help take out that excess moisture. Game changer. Another thing that will be an essential is keeping the sun out of your eyes. So in my build, I have these amazing window covers that I created. Link is in the description if you want to see how to make them yourself. And these will go over all of the windows. Another option, these pop-ups. I actually have a few of these. You can nuzzle these right in between. And all of a sudden you're blacked out. So I had like 5 of those at first. I used to put towels into the windows to block out the sun, or the best invention in the world, eye mask. Cover your eyes, you're good to go. The only thing is people will be able to see in your car. So if you are gonna do this long-term and not just a weekend at a campsite, I do recommend getting window covers. You're gonna want a good pillow. I have just my favorite pillow, but also my backpacking pillow. This thing is inflatable and it bunches up real small and goes into a small bag. Get a camp chair and a comfy one. I had a very uncomfortable one for the first 6 months and I regretted every second of it. So get a very comfy camp chair, spend the money, you'll thank me later. Water jug. One thing I would do is actually buy maybe a 5-gallon refillable water jug and just place it right over here, or have a bunch of these that you can refill. I don't recommend continually buying them. You can go into grocery stores or even campgrounds to refill them. Refillable jugs, we love them. First, you are gonna want a quality cooler. I started out with a plastic $20 cooler and I found myself getting ice every 2 days. It was not fun. It was worth the money. Every 5 to 6 days I'm filling ice. By the way, if you are a first-time cooler user, you do need to pre-chill your cooler. So put the ice in the day before and you'll find the ice isn't running through as fast. A lot of people first use their cooler and think it doesn't work. It's just because you have to pre-chill it. Not only is that important to have a cooler that fits there behind the seat in between the two seats, it's also a level for your head. Also in the past, I've used carry-on suitcases and sleeping pads. Whatever floats your boat. Some coolers don't come high enough. For instance, in my car, the cooler is level with where the seat is. In this car, it's not. So I took a few items to level it out. So this is gonna be all my zip ties, my cords, my Gorilla tape. So that goes right on top. And then I'll put my tent right on top there. And with the seat back, it's not gonna move. This is a $20 table. I got it at Walmart, and this is probably my favorite purchase of the year for the reason that it's so flat, it doesn't disturb your sleep, and is a great head level. Now it's not going anywhere. That's good. All right, let's check out this area. We have our dry cooler. Now this cooler is just for all of the dry foods. I just like having 2 levels on each side. This one's thin enough that the front seat can move back and forward. Otherwise, pile bags, whatever works for you, just try it out. And then I have these 2 really big plastic bins. This fits perfectly right in this door. I'm gonna go ahead and remove these and show you in depth what's inside. Come along. All right, now we're gonna get into the fun kitchen cooking stuff. Hey! In a spray bottle, I always have white vinegar. I personally love to clean with this. I will use this on my dishes after I eat. And then every few weeks, I'll go through with a really nice wash with soap when I have a sink available. Now on the topic of other solar items, this is my kitchen. Everything I use to cook and make coffee with is in this bag. Something that's important is going to be your fuel canister. Depending on the stove you use, there's different fuels, so check that out. I also have my AeroPress. This is what I use to make coffee. I have quite a bougie coffee setup, but let's say you are lazy. Instant coffee is also a great option for those who don't care as much. Next up is what I use to cook with. So I don't do really intense meals. I'll just do salads, soups, things like that. So when I am gonna make my soups, I have my jet boil with its attachment and this little, what do you call these? And this little, this goes on top of the stove. It's really easy, it's really great. So if you're like me and you wanna keep it simple, these are the things that you need. Some type of stove, doesn't have to be a jet boil, but this one boils water in 1 minute and we like that. All right, let's dive a little deeper into the kitchen setup. My huge salad bowl, my camp knife. Having a great knife is really a good idea. I actually have a few. Well, there was that roll of quarters. Always have quarters. So in this bag, I have a ton of plastic bags, trash bags, and all of my utensils, a can opener, and a tea seeper. Look at that unicorn, how cute. You can also just get a spork and use that single utensil. I just personally lose all my forks. I lose a fork every week and I don't know how. So I have a ton of utensils and bags. This is a really cool item. These are pop out wash sinks. So you can put water in here with soap and wash all of your things if you're with a big group. Since I really don't have that much, I just use my white vinegar. Love this. This is cool, huh? On the side here, this is just my bag of clothes. I had two of these actually, one for summer gear, one for winter gear. Depending on what you're doing, you might need one bag, you might need two bags. If you're gonna be doing this, you're probably gonna be outdoors. Think about where you're gonna be, what you're gonna be doing, and make sure you pack accordingly with rain gear, puffies, sun hat. At first, I had a suitcase. Not smart. You want something flexible that packs small. You don't use up all the room, so. Duffel bags like this are going to be a game changer. By the way, all these items are going to be in my Amazon links in the description if you want to look at them yourself. In the front here, we keep it open for passengers, but I will have my camp shoes. A good pair of camp shoes is so important. And hiking boots. Think about the activities you want to do and bring shoes accordingly. Solar lights, Lucy lights. These inflate all the way. When you turn them on, this works as a lantern and it charges up through the sun. I have this in my dash at all times. I do recommend these. One of my favorite lighting purchases. Another thing that's really important to have is some type of power bank. I personally have a very large power station that I use so I can work on the road. It has solar panels. It's a really great thing for full timers. I also make smoothies on there. Really cool. But let's say you're just doing a weekend, you might not need that unless you wanna use a plug-in cooker. It's pretty cool. This is a solar panel charger. Really easy. I also keep this in the dash. And this is just so if all you have is a phone, you can charge up your phone and you're good to go. Oh, don't forget your teepee. And I have tons of towels in my car, but one important thing is lightweight microfiber towels. They pack so small, they work great, and they dry so fast. I personally like having a lot of hand towels so I can clean stuff with it and I'm not wasting paper towels. I have this little string, right? And it's a bungee cord and it can attach from one side to another and you can hang all of your stuff on it. So it's good for when you're doing laundry. I do have a laundry bag that I use. When I want to do hand washes, this thing is super cool. Otherwise, most of the time I'm just going to laundromats. I always wrap them back up, but this ends up being a long string and it's just like a saw. I have a hatchet. You're just going to want all those essential tools in case of emergencies. It's a good idea. All right, next bin. I personally like hiking, so this will have everything from my hiking poles that collapse down. I have a water purifier. This is really amazing if you're near a freshwater source. So this literally makes it so you can drink any water and it takes everything out of it. I do recommend some type of water purifier or something like a life straw, as this is great for emergencies. You just never know depending on where you are if you're off grid. More utensils, because I just lose them all. Camp cup. Sunscreen and bug spray will save your life. Make sure you have those. One of my favorite items is this head net. I'm just gonna take it out and show you. When you're in buggy areas, this will change your life. This will keep all the mosquitoes off of your face. Looks silly, but you'll be thanking me later when you don't have a huge welt on your forehead. Oh, speaking of which, I just got bit. Headlamp. I actually have two of these. Super, super important. Did I turn that off? Yep. Extra batteries for my headlamp. Bear bell and bear spray. And a bear proof container, depending on the area you're in, is gonna be very important. And on the topic of bears and different wildlife, look up the area you're gonna be in, because chances are there might be different storage containers you need or things to look up, because you do not want a bear breaking into where you are. I've seen it happen many times.
Boy, bear.
Yeah. Ah!
First aid kit and all of my toiletries. Anything you would need for your hygiene and in a physical personal emergency. If you're like me and you like hiking, a really good backpack is gonna be a great idea. My charging cords and essentials like that. I just like having things in cute little compartments.
Other important items, you're gonna want a water bottle and a coffee cup, of course. Quarters, we always want quarters. You never know when you're gonna need them. Filling up air, car washes, coin showers at camp spots. I always have $15 of quarters. Another great thing to have is in the side doors, always have trash bags, hand sanitizer, and soap. I'm also a coconut oil fanatic, and this is where my emergency pee funnel goes. A
couple of people wanted to know what this was for. I'm desperate.
By the way, in my roof box is all of my sports gear. That's stuff that I didn't have in my first year because I didn't have the room. If you want to make the room, roof boxes are amazing.
My last item, yes, there are going to be many, many other items you can bring, but I found this is the essential small packing list setup to get started. As you go, you'll find the things that you need. The foldable camp shovel. Self-explanatory. This is so you can dig a hole if you're off-grid and there are no bathrooms. This is gonna bring me into my next subject, leave no trace principles. I cannot stress enough, if you are going to be camping, living on the road, being outdoors, you need to look up leave no trace principles. I'm gonna put a link in the description so you can look those up, but I urge you, there are so many things that I didn't even know had a bad impact on the environment or were affecting other people. Picking up your own trash, just be respectful of others. Leave where you go better than when you came. And there you have it. This is my no build, build guide for your car camping needs for first timers, beginners, or people who just wanna brush up. Before we go, a quick note from Skillshare. This is a website that I personally really like and I wanna share with you guys. Skillshare is an online learning community for creatives like myself and Camper who want to take their passions or their work to the next level. A membership gives you access to thousands of videos, like this one called YouTube Success, Script, Shoot, and Edit by Marquise Brownlee, rated the best this month by Skillshare. Skillshare is for any skill level. So beginner or advanced, they have something for you. And the best part, for the first 1,000 subscribers who click the link down in my description, you'll get a free 1 month trial membership. What do you want to tell them, Camper?
Don't forget to like, subscribe, comment, share with your friends, and turn on notifications. It really helps us out.
It really does help us out. And also, if you want to get all of our videos, early access, and ad-free, join our Patreon for as low as $1 a month. Thanks for watching. We love you all.
Kisses.